Alright guys, welcome to the Mountain Man Initiative today. I'm going to teach you how to pull this bad boy apart for part 2, and then look out for part 3 where I show you how to put it all back together again. But today what we want to do is grab our socket set and disconnect our battery before we start, because A, we don't want to be fighting with our puller here today, and then we have a bunch of beeps and honks and all that fun stuff, and plus there's electrical stuff in here that we don't want to mess up or ground out by accident. So do keep that in mind. So let's go ahead and disconnect our battery real quick, and then we'll start tearing everything apart. Alright guys, I got the hood open. We're here at our battery. For me, I'm going to pull off the negative first. That's the side you want to start with. For me, this is going to be a 13 millimeter socket. We're just going to break that nut free and then unthread it a bit so it's nice and loose. They're going to wiggle this off and set it aside where it's going to be safe and it's not going to mess up anything, and we'll be good to go. Alright, let's jump back into the truck and start pulling apart the steering wheel. Alright guys, we're back in the truck. The first thing you want to do is make sure your steering wheel is loose and you have parked as straight as possible, wheels are straight and all that fun stuff. So that way everything's in alignment, and if for some reason your steering wheel is locked, as you know, just stick the key in there and then it will unlock it and just put it in a natural resting position and we'll be good to go. Alright guys, before we get any further, let's go ahead and grab our Sharpie and our straight edge, or that piece of paper I showed you in last week's video. And what we're going to do is we're going to come here and we're just going to draw a line with the steering wheel on top. I prefer this over the paper if possible. And you're just going to make a small mark to index it, just like so. So that way you can get it back together straight. And if it's not, then when you put it back together again, you can at least put it back together straight. So from here, what we're going to do is we're going to grab our horn and it's just going to pop off like so. You're going to unpull one tab and then the other. It don't really matter here. Just pull it apart and we'll be good to go. Set that aside. And then we got this nut here. We need to get this nut off. And that's what our breaker bar for is. For me, it was this good old 13/16 hex. It's what fits on here. And it goes like so. What you're going to do is then come here and break it up. Break it. And if your steering wheel locks here, that's fine. That's not a problem. That's gonna happen. We just wanted it loose so that way we could index it properly, so that way we could put it back on straight. And we're gonna take that and our magnet tray and put that in there. We're gonna set that there where we don't have to worry about it. Now since that is free, what we're gonna want to do is grab our puller. And these heads for me, oh, that's the wrong size, is these good old 14 millimeter. That's what that's going to be for me. Set that on my magnet tray so I don't lose it. And then we're going to back this out for a minute here, and then we'll be good to go. That way we got some slack. And then we're going to take this and start on one side. And these are could be pretty challenging. These threads on here, they're pretty tight tolerance, so it might take you a minute to get it. Alright, once you got your threads finally started, it took me a minute to do it for whatever reason, you're just going to take it down and you're just going to hand tighten these down all the way. You don't need to ratchet them on here, you just need maybe to make sure they bottom out. So that way all the threads are going to help you and you don't strip or mess up anything. This is why we wanted to back this out earlier, so we got some slop in here to tighten these down and we're not going to mess anything up. Alright, so once you got these right here good to go and they're bottom out, what you're going to do is you're going to do this part by hand. Is you're going to come here and you're going to hand do this and get it all lined up so you don't mess up the indentation, but at the same time it actually pulls evenly like it's supposed to. So once you get it hand started, that's for me for this tool. Like I said, you're going to want the extendo right here for leverage and the 5/8 socket, and then this is where you're going to ratchet down and you'll be good to go. So you're gonna come here and you're just gonna keep on going, and I can tell you it's already free, you'll feel it, but you want to make sure you back it off plenty so that way you're completely off those splines so you don't jack them up. Alright, so we're good there, and then it's gonna pull off like so, and you can set that to the side. Alright guys, y'all probably going, what in tarnation is going on here? And you'd be absolutely correct. So what you got here are these threads here for your nut that holds your steering wheel into place, and then here are the splines that lock into the steering wheel so you could turn properly. This here is your locking plate, and right here you do this, and then that's how your steering wheel locks with this pin, because it interfaces with that, and that's what's causing it to lock. This is all under tension, this locking plate with a spring, and that's what this decompressor tool is for, which I'm about to show you how to use. And then you got this retaining ring here is what we're about to pop off. That's what your pocket knife is going to be for, screwdriver, picky tool, anything to help you get that out. And you don't want to lose it, you want to save it. That's very important, because probably good luck getting another one, right? Alright guys, once you grab your locking plate tool, there's actually two sides of this, and this pin is what holds it in place. You want to make sure you grab the 9/16 side here by, I guess it says 13, I can't quite read that. Anyways, you're going to take your tool and you're going to put it on here, but there's two ways you could do it. I prefer having the tool upright like this. Some people prefer doing it like this. It's going to be whatever is easiest for you to get the ring, that snap ring out. I prefer doing it this way. And then you're just going to come on like so, and you're going to go ahead and thread it on, and once you thread it on until it bottoms out, you'll be good to go. Okay, so now we're bottom out. What we're going to do is make sure this is pretty much lined up and good to go, and this big old wing nut here is what you're going to start using, and you're going to keep on tightening it down and decompressing it all the way. You want it to bottom out. You need all the room you could get, because this ring could be a pain. Alright, so now you can grab your picky tool, screwdriver, or good old trusted pocket knife. I have personally used the screwdriver and pocket knife before. I actually prefer using a thinner bit like this. Makes it a lot easier. So it's up to you, just what you have available to get it off. Alright, now we got it out of that recess here where it was sitting, because there's a spot here and it's on top of these splines. So just what you're going to do is you're going to pull it here. Once you get here, you can actually get this off. So now what you're going to do is decompress your locking plate and just keep on going until it's nice and loose again. Alright, and then you unthread the top like you just put it on. Set that to the side where you ain't gonna have to worry about. Take your ring, put it in the magnet tray. Your cog doesn't quite fit in the magnet tray, that's okay. This is for your horn, so you can go honk honk. This interfaces down in here with this pin and the blinker, and it'll be good to go. Alright guys, since your steering wheel and locking plate is now out of the way, I'm gonna actually show you how to pull out your blinker switch. There's a total of 5 screws you're gonna actually have to remove. So you got this one here, you got this one, that one, and this one. And if you're like an idiot like I am, for the hunter's time, I do forget, you actually need to remove this guy right here. This is your hazard switch. If you have your hazard switch here, you're not going to get it out of the way. It's a little baby screw. So everything else is going to be the 2-size Phillips, and then I would recommend using the number 1 size for the baby screw in here. So before we forget, let's go ahead and knock out the hazard switch and get that out of the way, because that's going to interrupt the whole process. Alright, so this is one piece here that you need to remember and not lose. Do remember it's this long, coarse, skinny one that goes into here, that's that little bitty bit. Go ahead and put that in your magnet tray. Put this somewhere you're not going to lose it. Alright, cool. Let's go ahead and put our number 2 size head back on. What we're going to do is grab this, and we're going to start with this one right here. That's this screw that interfaces with this bar that interfaces with your lever here. That's how it moves, or what engages it, everything to move. So let's go ahead and unscrew this and get it out of the way. So this is your bar it interfaces with. And then it uses this little screw, coarse screw here. Go ahead and put that where it's not going to get all mixed up. Go ahead and move this down. And then go ahead and do this. And pull all the other 3 out, and it will come free. Alright, and once they're all unthreaded or unscrewed, it will come right on out here. So what you're gonna wanna do is grab these before you lose them, these more medium-sized coarse threads. I'll grab that here in a second. All right, since I'm done struggling with that, I'm gonna show you how to get some more slack out of this, because there's gonna be no way to finish pulling everything apart with this much slack. So what you're gonna do is take your handy dandy screwdriver again, and you're gonna get underneath to this panel here. Right here, you got these two screws and then these two, making a total of four. And that's what you wanna pull apart, and that's what's gonna give you a lot more slack to get everything undone. So let's go ahead and pull off this service panel. All right, since now you got everything unscrewed, you're gonna go ahead and drop this bad boy off. This panel actually just pops off, so go ahead and keep that, set it to the side. So this is where a lot of your breakers and relays are. So remember what I was telling you when I had to replace that old blue one with the new blinker relay? It's this guy right here. This is the one that does all the blinking and all the flashing. So this is the new one that's in here. Like I said, you could check out the descriptions and all the fun stuff for the past video for all the parts and tools you'll need. But anyways, like I said, that's the blinker switch and the relay. And so what you want to do too to gain more slack is you actually drop this out. It just falls right out. It's really easy. And set that aside where you're not going to lose it. Now you got all these wires here that are a lot more free and loose. So from here, you can actually just come out here and pop that, and you'll be good to go. Now you got a lot of slack and you don't got to worry about it. So before we get to really ripping this thing any further, what you need to do is pay attention to two things. First off, it's going to be this. This is your buzzer switch for, hey moron, you left the lights on. So right here. So that's what this is. So you're going to go ahead and set that to aside so you don't actually lose it. Don't put that in the magnet tray because it's not going to stick very well. And so also right here in the key barrel, there's actually a thing that looks like a bobby pin. That's the key buzzer switch too. When I did this before to put this new switch in, because inspection, I lost it and gained a fourth screw for the panel down there. Don't know how that happens or why, but it did. So for you guys here, this is the spring that's been compressed for the locking plate. That's what this is. You can pull it out before the switch. It just happened to be easier to do it this way for me today, so this just happened to be the case. Put that on your magnet tray so you don't lose it. So you got these bad boy here. These are going to be the next three that you're going to use to get further into this. And I'm about to show you that here in just a second. Alright guys, these star-sized bits here are going to be a T27 here. Put it on the end of your screwdriver here and go ahead and unthread them. These should not be too terribly tight. They should be in there firm, like a quarter of a turn. And we'll just knock them all out. Alright guys, now once those are all off, you want to remove your key barrel, but at the same time you can remove it earlier. It just depends on you. But I'm showing you what's all in your way to actually rip it apart bit by bit. That's probably going to trip you up. To remove the key barrel, it's very easy. You actually got this point right here that indexes with, and you actually take a small, like a flathead screwdriver, and you just stick it in here. And there's this black pin that's sitting there, and then it just, once you depress that and you pull on it, right, it'll come right out like so. And so right here, it's this pin that's what's holding you into place, and that's pretty much it, nice and simple. All right, once your key barrel's taken out, it's pretty easy now. This actually falls apart. You actually have a piece in here that might drop on you. So go ahead and pull it off and be careful so you don't lose anything. And once you do that, it just hangs like that. See, it's this piece right here that will get away from you, and you'll wonder what the hell it is. This is actually a spacer. So it's this bar here, so you have your brights. So it will interface like that, and I'll show you how you put it all back together. Again, it's pretty tricky. But set this aside where you don't lose it. Alright guys, so right here is your locking pin, right? So sometimes this doesn't always seat back right when you put it back together again. So it'll look like that or kind of janky. This loop here, this top loop, is supposed to sit here in this plastic piece. That's what's going to allow it to lock. So FYI there. This will just dangle here. And this top bar here is for the ignition, and this bottom bar here is for your brights. So when you do rip this apart, sometimes this bad boy actually falls out, as in you'll pull it out or something. And so underneath here, you got this green switch right here. That's your dimmer switch, and that's what this bar goes into. So you have your brights and your low beams. All right, guys, you're probably asking me, all right, well, now I need to do the blinker switch. How do I replace it? Well, I'm not gonna leave you empty-handed, which I'm gonna tell you how to do right now. Not show, but definitely tell. So what we're gonna do here is actually you're gonna take your adjustment bar and this tilt steering wheel, and you're gonna make it as straight as possible. You want it to look like it left the factory as one solid piece. And then you're gonna feed it through here and pull it through here, which is an absolute hassle. That's why you want this as straight as possible. So if you crawl down here through our sea of mess, past all our fun stuff, you got these wires all up in here, right? So this wire here that runs down into this junction box is actually your blinker switch wires. That's what's there. And this is your cable management right here. This is basically a taco with two Christmas trees on each side. You just pull that off and it'll gain you all the room and access you need to pull it through there. It is an absolute pain. There'll be struggling and yanking, and putting it back through is going to be a bit of a challenge too. When you do it, you want to put it in here at the right angle where it goes into. I learned if you have the ports, the holes this way for the pins to go into, and out this way, you can push it through here. And then what you want is to do it all by hand as much as possible, then grab a screwdriver and then push it all the way through, and then it will go all the way through. So that is how you tear all this apart down to level for maintenance, to replace the blinker switch and all that fun stuff. Anything excessive from here on out, because your steering wheel is loose, is going to be some pretty expensive stuff. And you get further into that by pulling this guy apart here by you unscrew it, if I recall correctly. Just be careful, and that's when you get to the U-joint and all that fun stuff. Thank you for watching part two of the teardown on actually how to make a mess of things, how to get into it, and what to look for, and all that fun stuff. Now I'm about to show you how to put it back together again in next week's episode of episode 3. So stay tuned in for that. Don't forget to look in the bottom for all the tools you'll need if you missed last week's episode on how to do this. I also have diagrams up now on the blog, all that fun stuff. So like, comment, subscribe, tell me what you thought, what you want to see in the future. I got wheel bearings I'm probably going to do tomorrow and film, and be working on that with diagrams. So definitely let me know.